I think in the modern digital age, we have to think HD, and HD is coming whether we like it or not. And the thing about HD in modern production is that screens are getting bigger and bigger every year. And if you're lighting good quality HD, any production in HD, you've got to be really careful, because when you see these images on a big screen, you're going to see every single wrinkle and every fault. So high quality lighting, I think, is important, but also thinking about your end user, whether you're producing HD for the big screen, for theatre, for cinema, to go on television, or to go on the internet. Regardless of the end user, you have to be careful about what you're shooting, careful about what you're lighting, and the composition is also important, because this seems to be forgotten art, and delivering high quality images that appear to be three-dimensional on a two-dimensional screen, whether it's a cinema screen or a computer screen, is extremely important. Lighting budgets are quite often left to the end of a production, or to the end of the purchase of filming equipment. And I feel it's a shame, because lighting seems to be the least important part of film production. People buy their software, then the camera, then the tripod, and then go, ah, I need some light. Light is paramount to high quality images, and choosing high quality tools to do a good job with is important. So if you have a limited budget, I sincerely hope that you can save up and buy some high quality tools, because these will last you a long time. And applying good quality light to your pictures and your sets will actually improve the quality of your images and your reputation. And it's important that you do this, because if you just turn the light on and illuminate a scene, anybody can do this. But lighting to high quality, and not just using any old lights, will make a huge difference to your finished product. I think when you're choosing lighting tools for different productions, you do have to choose carefully, because you have to look at the script, what the script or the production calls for, and whether you choose hard light or soft light. That is down to you and the aesthetic importance of what you're producing. But if you're a gaffer looking for tools, tools from companies like Kinoflow, Datalight, Photoflex, these are all high quality tools. When you choose your tools, choose them well, because you need equipment that's going to last and do a really good job. People tend to choose tools that maybe are cheap and they will fall apart, but your lighting tools are really important. And choosing hard lighting tools like Datalight or the Parabeam series of Kinoflow lights for studio, for example, these are very, very good tools. If you want softer lights, the softer Kinoflows, the Diva lights, and things like the Photoflex tools that you can probably see here, are extremely good and portable and extremely valuable tools in creating high quality pictures. High key lighting is quite an art. There are a lot of things that affect your final image. You can use Fresnels to create hard light, but maybe this is not the best idea. You can actually create pretty hard light with the top end range of fluorescent lighting from Kinoflow, for argument's sake, and you can tailor your image with not just the light, it's the set around you that can create a huge difference, but also what's going on in the electronics of that camera. The gamma of a camera is really important. This is something that is very rarely touched upon, things like the black stretch in these smaller cameras, that can affect the quality of your image as well. Filtration also can make a huge difference. For argument's sake, putting polar filters in changes the image quality. Putting pro mists and things, that always changes the quality as well. But take care when you're creating high quality, high contrast images, because if you create a high contrast image and you crush the black shadows, there are times when you will not be able to recover this, and you tend to be able to do more if you shoot a medium contrast than a fairly high gamma. And with digital photography, you can actually expand that or change that or crush it more in post-production. So be really careful when you're shooting high contrast, high key pictures. When you're shooting blue or green screen, it's really important that you match lighting of the background plate to the foreground action. This is an art, and I could send you an invoice for this if you wish, because it's not an easy thing to do. But it is really important to match the lighting, because you need the shadows, if you are shooting a live background, the shadows on the background plate that's going in where the blue or green is, the shadows need to be in the same direction that are on the face in the foreground that you're going to do the live action with. So you need to match the direction of the light, foreground and background, but also to accurately match the colour. So if you have 5600 degrees Kelvin exterior, you have to match that light and quality of light on the interior. That's a whole different ball game and quite an art. And then if you look on the internet, there are websites that will tell you how to do that. But it does take some time and quite an art in doing so. But be careful with how you do it. It's not as easy as you may think. I think Asia is a really, really interesting part of the world. And the West knows a little bit about you, because we have an awful lot of your food. And the things that really excite Westerners about Asia, and things that you should actually make films about, are travel, holidays, really interesting people, your customs and your celebrations, things that you celebrate here that visitors can come and see and enjoy and join in with you. But also something that I'm passionate about is your wines, your foods, and things like that, that people can actually do and create at home if they can make the food, or actually come to your countries and really enjoy your drinks and your food and your culture. This is what really excites people.